Hi, I'm Kai Echardt, and check me out at forbassplayersonly.com with John Liebman.
Hi everyone, I'm John Liebman. You're watching forbassplayersonly.com. Today we are here actually at the Warwick World Headquarters in Markneukirchen, Germany. And I am here with the one and only Kai Echardt. How are you, Kai?
I'm very good. Thank you very much, John. It's an honor once again. It's the second time, right?
Yes, we did an interview, I don't remember how long, it was a while back.
2 years.
Yeah. Yes, and it's a great interview. It's still on the site for Bass Players Only interviews, Kai Echardt. But you're a busy guy. You're always doing something cool. So bring us up to date, first of all, on what you've been up to since we last spoke.
Well, first of all, a not so fun news is that my band Garage Mahal broke up. And that was very sad for me. I was holding on to dear life. But it all just sort of fell apart, and our keyboarder went to Night Ranger. So, you know, we just ended up calling it a day. And so for, I guess, a couple of years, I was scrambling, you know, trying to figure out what to do next. And I'm proud to actually say I've gotten to a place right now where I have all my ducks in a row. And there's a brand new album, there's a brand new band, brand new endorsement, and also a foundation.
Tell me about the new band.
Well, I copied the John McLaughlin model. And when John met me in 1988, he basically had the concept of looking for younger musicians that were really talented, that could help him develop his vision. And so, you know, now that Garage Mahal is no longer, I decided, okay, it's time for me to try it out as a band leader. And I wanted to look for younger musicians who are extremely talented. So I looked around for a long time. And I found three amazing musicians. Like, one of them is Australian. He's a guitarist from Sydney, Chris Robinson. And I have Osam Ezeldin on the keyboards, who is from Cairo, Egypt. He got a full scholarship to Berkeley and a green card through Berkeley, and ended up moving to San Francisco just to join the band. And then there is the amazing Dana Hawkins, who was in Esperanza Spalding's band playing drums. He's from the gospel tradition, also went through Berklee College. He lives in Baltimore. But we got together to do this album. And
this album?
Yes. In fact, this is the new record. The Zeitgeist by Kai Echardt. So those are all my compositions.
Zeitgeist.
Except for the Giant Steps. There's a slap bass version of...
You didn't write Giant Steps? tell me about your endorsement. Has something to do with an amplifier?
Yes. I met Hans-Peter Wilfer, online.
The head of Warwick.
Yes, exactly.
And you can see behind us the administrative offices of Warwick. In Markneukirchen, Germany. I said it before, but it's fun to say. Can you say Markneukirchen?
Yeah, Markneukirchen.
So tell me about your new amplifier endorsement. Where there goes Jonas Hellborg. Does he have anything to do with it?
Well, Jonas and I go way back. He was the person who was in McLaughlin's band before I got there. Actually, there was Jeff Berlin before, but Jonas goes way back. So it seems Jonas has gotten really tight with Warwick, and evidently he's a designer now. And yes, so I'm always happy to see him.
Tell me about your amp.
I'm playing the LWA-1000, which is a tiny amp that has two channels. And it is just a sweet amplifier, like you plug in your bass and it automatically sounds good. It doesn't have extreme EQ. Like some amps, you know, if you move the EQ around, it's like your bass starts to change sounds into something else you don't recognize. So this is a very fine little amp. It's very subtle and warm sounding for a transistor. Actually, I wasn't really looking for an endorsement, but HP contacted me. And I was attracted to his personality because he was so friendly and so respectful. And I was like, I really like this person. I will check out his stuff.
I've never heard a negative word spoken about him.
Yeah, so And that's how it happened, you know. The little amp came in the mail. I checked it out. It was awesome.
You mentioned that it's small, but it is mighty and it is powerful.
Yeah, absolutely. It's really, really nice craftsmanship. I haven't really turned it all the way up because I'm not, you know, a super, super loud kind of a guy. I don't need it. I'd blow myself away. But yeah, so far I have not seen any weaknesses on this amplifier.
Now tell me about your new foundation. I know you're very excited about that.
The Echardt Foundation currently has three wings. One of them is very personal. I'm basically reaching out to homeless people. I go out, I befriend them, you know, especially the people who are around my studio. That is a very poor neighborhood. And I ask them for permission to do an interview. So I do the interview and I offer them some money for it. And I also make a wish list. I ask them what do you need? If you had a wish list of what you need right now, and so it goes all the way from sleeping bags to new upholstery for the couch, an old couch, very modest little things actually. And then I record their life story. In about a half an hour, I get some stories from them. And so it will be an album project. So I'm taking my band into the recording studio. We're writing about 10 to 12 songs. And each song is going to be dedicated to one person who is either homeless or in some way underprivileged. And then I'm going to present it like a package. So here's the album. And here are the dedications. And for the specific songs, I'm going to make press CDs and hand that to these people so that they can also hand that to others and show that off. And so the idea behind it is that it's important for us as a society to make a statement that those are also part of our extended family, that if someone has fallen upon hard times, we as a society have an obligation to make sure they do not fall into that abyss of a non-dignified life. And that is part of the problem right now, that these are extraordinary people. Like, I also want to show the amazing stories that they have to tell.
Kai, I've always known you're a great bass player, but you are obviously so much more than that. And I think it's beautiful that you recognize this problem, and more importantly, you're doing something to help confront the problem and ultimately wipe it out, or at least do what you can do to make a dent in it. Much, much appreciated on behalf of everyone involved. I know I speak for everyone. Last question, Kai. What would you be if you were not a bass player? Something outside of music.
Wow, that's a good question. I would probably be some kind of Mother Teresa kind of person, you know? I think really I have the highest respect for people who have compassion towards the really hardcore cases, you know, of, you know, people who are sick or mentally ill. Like, I have a real respect for the caretakers, you know, the hospice workers. So I could see myself going in that direction, but I would always be an artist because that's my outlet, you know. There is also a danger when you're in touch with a lot of sadness. It can rub off on you. It can get you depressed, you know. So I think music is a way for me to keep my balance. So I would probably end up picking up either painting or music as a way to keep my mental balance. But I would be doing humanitarian work for sure.
Well, that's great. You would be doing even more humanitarian work than you're already doing, which is great. The new band, the new record, the new foundation, everything else. Kai Echardt, great catching up with you.
Thank you, John. Always
thank you so much. And we are at the Warwick World Headquarters, Markneukirchen, Germany. I'm John Liebman. You're watching for BassPlayersOnly.com.